Welcome to the FABLOW AgriLife podcast, where we promote better living for healthy Texans. Every episode, we'll cover a health or wellness topic, as well as some lifestyle challenges that we face. All right, so this is Jocelyn. We're back with the FABLOW episodes. We have the whole gang here. Everyone say hi.
Hello.
Hi.
So this episode is about back to school, and we're going to go over some different topics. But Nicole, take it away.
Okay, so like she said, we're talking about back to school. I wanted to touch a little bit on child passenger safety. So I have a couple events coming up, or Drew and I have a couple events. We have one September 16th in Floresville. And it's a car seat event, so if you need your car seat inspected, reach out to me and we'll get you an appointment. And then Drew has one here in Atascosa County on September 24th.
It's going to be in Pleasanton.
So we'll have to reach out to get on our appointment list, but reach out to us. Child passenger safety is really a huge issue in both of our counties. Especially with everybody going back to school, we see a lot of kids in the car line that are either sitting up front when they're not supposed to be. So just to let you know, 13 years and younger need to be in the back seat. That's the state law. And then if you have younger ones that still require a booster seat, they need to be 4'9" or higher height-wise, to get out of a booster seat. So
and
we can check
pounds.
That some.
And the yeah. 40 pounds. A lot of times we think our kids are big because they're going to kindergarten and, oh, I'm a big kid now. They want to get out of their booster seat or even out of their five-point harness. But most of the time they still even need that five-point harness.
I think we actually one time had a middle schooler who was still in a booster seat because of her height.
Yes.
So you got to think about that, the height and weight. It's not about their age as much as we love to think so. It's about their height and weight. So,
and even, you know, we're seeing an increase on the smaller, the younger kids that are, you know, a little bit bigger height and weight wise. We still need to consider keeping them into a harness because of their bone structure. Their bones are still developing and they need that extra five-point harness to keep them safe in the car just in case something happens.
But I was going to say, call our office. We can usually help you at least check your car seat. I know in Frio County I cannot provide a free car seat, but we can get you some resources. But come to the events. You will definitely learn how to install a car seat, and you will learn all the information you need because it is a lot of information, but it's good, useful information that you can use not only for one child but for all your children. Depending if you have a lot of kids.
Yes, 9 out of 10 car seats are put in wrong, and you think they're put in right. So it's just statistically wise, we need to do it right.
And it's even better to bring family members. So if you have grandparents taking your kids, maybe you want them to come in. It's always good to have family members also educated in it. I know because of my niece. Well, I'm teaching everybody because like, everyone has her in some vehicle. I'm like, no, install it this way. So it's good to get everyone educated on that information. Anything
definitely.
Else?
Well, if you have teen drivers now, that's a big deal too. So my son is starting to drive. He doesn't have his license yet, but he has his permit.
Well, we're over here hands on the chest because we know how Drew is a warrior.
Yes. So, but there is also a law. It's the Texas Graduated Driver's License Law, and the restriction it puts in place, including no cell phone use and no more than one passenger under 21 in the vehicle unless the passenger is related to the driver. So they cannot, like when I was growing up, all my friends piled into my car and we went. Now my son can take my other son, and that's it.
Very true.
So you have to realize that. So it's not like they can do the carpool thing like I used to do.
I did it in high school too. I was thinking about it.
Yeah, I used to go and pick everybody up and we would go to school because I was the first one to get my license. Mm-hmm. And now we can't do that. And so just be aware of that law. Be aware that they should not be using cell phones. And sometimes that's us not texting them or calling them when you know they're on the road.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's hard. Maybe,
yes.
And there is an app now. I'll put it on their blog, but there is an app where you can turn on your phone into text driving. Or I think the iPhone has that option too.
The iPhone has it. And there's also, there's a new app that actually you can earn points for every mile you go that you don't touch your phone. And then you earn points for... It's through Safe Kids. They're teaming up with somebody to do this. And we'll get more information on that, and we'll put it out in the FABLOW newsletter.
So it's just for teens or...
It's for everybody, actually, because we all have a problem with it.
We do. I do, too, sometimes.
I know we all try to,
Even with the smart vehicles, when they're like, read it to you, I'm like, what? What happened?
Yeah, you're trying to tell it to, you know, talk back and text back. And it gets it all wrong. You're like, no, I didn't say any of that.
Yes.
What happened here?
It's Safe to Save. It's an app-based program that enables drivers to receive points for every mile they drive without touching their phone. Users can redeem their points for prizes like free food, coffee, and entertainment.
I was going to say, what do we win? And now that I hear food. I
know. Yes.
We're on board.
Downloading now.
We're all broke from summer.
It is. They're actually kicking it off, it looks like, today. So it's gonna. It's a new partnership with them. Yeah, they actually kicked it off today, but it's an app, and we will get that...
On our
information
blog. Yeah.
On our blog and newsletter.
For sure. That's good.
And speaking of teen driving, I just want to put this in there. Guys, we know there's a lot of teens on the road, especially right now. They're going to and from school. Give them their space. Let them drive. We know they're not the best drivers. Heck, most of us aren't great drivers anyway, so we need...
Okay, I got it.
Not mentioning any names.
They're calling me out, people. It's
so awesome. Give them their space. Let them. They're going to make mistakes, so just make sure you're aware of that.
Yes. That's what insurance
Don't be
for.
A jerk.
My son, you know, like I said, he has his permit, and I have a sticker or like a magnet on the back of my car that says caution or please be patient, teen driver, or new driver, and screaming parent. And usually that's what it is. So,
I think that in my car in general.
So it is. Just give them space. They're trying to learn to show, lead by example, not checking your phone.
Also, not what's it called? Road rage.
Yes.
Work on that, parents.
I will say we took our kids to school yesterday morning, and trying to keep my mouth shut on the ins and out of school traffic was not easy. And then, but we did. On the way to school, there's a 3-car wreck on 775 there. And then after school, we went to go get school supplies, and there was a wreck right outside of HEB. And so this is just people being in a hurry. There's more traffic right now. Kids are crossing the road. Please pay attention to those little ones. Teach your little ones that are maybe just starting school where to get out of the car, not to run towards you, not to, you know, they're so excited because they're out of school. They usually schools try to help with that and the teachers, but, you know, there are those kids that say, oh, there's my mom, and take off. Mm-hmm. So please teach them, give pedestrians the right of way, slow down in parking lots.
And pay attention to those blinking lights when it's telling you to slow down, tickets.
Mm-hmm. Yes, traffic fines do double, you know, in school zones and stuff. Mm-hmm. So just be careful when school buses, do not pass them. There's children getting out of the car, getting out of that bus, sometimes on highways. I know where we are, they're getting out of the car they're getting out of that bus, and they're having to cross a highway. We just want to make sure we give them enough room and be aware of that.
Have a buddy.
Yeah. That's what that all goes back to paying attention, being off your phone, not texting and driving, not looking at it, but actually focus on driving.
Or earphones, if they're listening to music. You have to be aware of your surrounding. I'm guilty of that when I'm walking my dogs. I can imagine kids walking to school.
Earbuds in or something.
Yes, because you can't hear the...
So put it low, guys, if you have earphones.
One in, one out, something, whatever works so you can still hear what's going on around you.
Mm-hmm. Any final tips on passenger safety?
Just be careful out there. Try to, like you said, slow down. There used to be the saying, arrive alive. That's the kind of the deal. That's what I talked to my son about is like, if you're 5 minutes late, well, you're 5 minutes late. You're still alive. You didn't hurt anybody. Mm-hmm. You know, people can deal with being upset because you're late more than they can deal with you getting hurt in a car accident or anything. Just be patient. There's no reason. Less stress, too, because when you do start getting that road rage, you're just, we've all done it, where you're just like, ah! And so, but once you relax and sit back, your blood pressure goes down. It's just a whole health issue at that point.
Mm-hmm. That's my new slogan, Arrive Alive.
It should be.
So anytime I'm late for work, I'm going to be, I arrived alive. You're welcome.
And sometimes that's what it is, because, you know, we think, oh my gosh, we have to be there right at this time. Right. And, you know, if you...
Stuff happens.
Yeah.
Plan ahead.
We end up having, you know, my house is 15 minutes, no traffic to my office. So when we have to have meetings in San Antonio, there's always traffic.
Yes.
And I'm like, it shouldn't take me this long to get there. Mm-hmm. So
it's true.
I'm going to start telling them that. I arrived alive.
I love that. But we're going to finish it off with some cool packing, a safe lunch, some little snippets about packing a lunch for school or for work.
Yes, so first and foremost, make sure that you're keeping your area clean when you are packing your lunch, and washing your hands with warm water and soap, and just making sure that we're really, really preventing any cross-contamination or anything from happening. And so we want to make sure we have a clean area, and making sure that we're keeping our foods out of that temperature danger zone. So that's 40 degrees Fahrenheit to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So we want to prevent it from keeping in that. And so what that means is making sure your foods are cold, that are supposed to be cold, and the ones that are hot, that are kept hot. So we want to make sure that perishable foods like lunch meats or any cheese, milk, any already cut fruit, that we already have like an ice pack in our lunch box and make sure, you know, it's been frozen overnight, it's really, really cold. That way it keeps those foods cold until you eat it at lunch. Some foods that are good at room temperature, so nuts and peanut butter is always okay. Any unopened containers like a pudding or juice boxes, those are okay. Any dried fruit, chips, those are okay at room temperature. But like your lunch meats and cheeses and milk, really, really make sure that those stay at the coldest that you can get it. Also, make sure you're keeping your lunchbox clean. So,
sometimes those get nasty.
Yeah, make sure like after school things get tossed out and thrown away. Don't eat it, and don't leave it in there. Yeah, don't leave it in there either, to where you get something very, very nasty here in a couple of days. So make sure you're keeping those lunchboxes clean as well. And then if you're using a paper bag, only use it once. So don't just keep reusing it. Just toss it out.
It's going to get worn out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I mean, what child, I wouldn't keep track of it, but especially a child keeping track of your paper bag, you know? Yeah, yeah. So
I would lose it.
Well, now we have a lot of reusable bags and stuff. Make sure you're washing them every day before you're putting new chips, or even if you're putting the same chip in there, make sure you're washing it before you put the different chips in, or even the same, you know, for the next day, making sure they know, because nothing is more disgusting than opening a lunchbox on Monday morning after it's been sitting there for the weekend that, oh gosh, where's my lunch? It's disgusting. Mm-hmm. Sometimes containers just go in the trash because of that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Not opening this.
That would be horrible. Any final thoughts, guys? No? Have a great school year.
Bye.
Stay safe.
Be mindful.
Just breathe.
Stay sweet. And stay fab.
You've been fabloed.